Hi and welcome to our show. This is our first show in English only. My name is Ronny Rønning. I live in Norway. I'm Norwegian. And this is my co-host and my fiancé.
Yes, I'm Anneli Virtanen. I'm Finnish.
Yeah, she's Finnish. And we had have doing this for a couple of years in Norway with live streaming, live shows in a couple of years. And we have about 12,000 followers on Facebook, where we have mainly have been doing our broadcast. And that it's a good number in Norway because we have only 5.5 million citizens. Mm-hmm. And if we are, have been, what do you call it, counting on it? If you compare it with the USA and their number of citizens, it would be about 800,000 followers.
Yeah, we're actually quite big in Norway.
Yeah,
quite big.
And some people have said that we should start doing live shows like we do in Norway in English.
And, yeah, why not?
Yeah. Especially people in Finland have asked for that.
Yeah.
Because they don't understand Norwegian. Yeah. And some of it don't understand Swedish.
And things are looking pretty bad in Europe and also in the north in Scandinavia. So actually, I think people are interested in to know what is happening in Norway, Sweden, Finland, Denmark,
yeah, and
rest of the Europe.
And maybe see the way we see it from our view in the rest of the world. How we see the rest of the world, what happened in the rest of the world from with Scandinavian eyes,
yeah,
to put it that way. And we are, since it's the first time we are broadcasting on Twitch, we're trying that first, see how it goes. You have to practice our English.
Yeah.
And I see we have some issues with the chat box. We should have a chat box here, but it don't work yet. So we'll see if it will pop out during the broadcast. This will not be a very long show. We have to tune us in. Try it out.
Yeah, try it out.
Try it out in English, yeah, and see how it goes. So where do you want to start, Anneli? Should we do...
Maybe we should start in Sweden.
Mm-hmm.
I told you I'm Finnish. I am Finnish, but I have been living in Sweden for almost over 25 years. So Sweden is my second home country. And... Sweden is looking pretty bad right now.
I can see how, if I find the links that you got, is this this one?
Yeah.
You can show it up. And this, some others?
I have three of them. Because that's the first one.
First one, second one, sorry about this. And the third one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yesterday, there was a global big sting. An operation called Trojan Shield.
What link do you want to start? I want to
we
show
can take
those
that
links.
One.
That one?
First, yeah.
That one first, yeah. Okay.
And it was quite successful with that operation because they made over 800 arrests in 16 countries.
Mm. In Europe or
yes,
or
in no, I thought I think it, Australia. Was also, so it wasn't just Europe. The thing was that they used phone, planted phones. The FBI used planted phones, and officers were able to read messages of global underworld figures in about 100 countries. And in Sweden, they could, of the total of 12,000 users of that platform, Swedish police had access to about 1,600 accounts.
Mm.
And that's why they could arrest in Sweden 155 people. That's quite a lot of 800. In Norway, there was only 7 arrests. In Finland, there was 100 arrests. And Australia said they charged more than 200 people. But you see, Sweden have quite a few people there. And this happened yesterday, early in the morning. They were I don't know what they call this. They say called Trojan shield, but they used something called anum devices. I don't know what that is. Some
what technical do you call it? Item devices.
Anum devices.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's what's the thing. And the Swedish police officers say many of those persons were with essential roles and heavy influence on the drug market, and some murderers too. The article don't say how what kind of people they were arresting in Norway. That would have been very interesting to know. Have you heard anything about it?
No, I haven't heard about it, especially not in the mainstream media. And that's why we are here, to broadcast and show what the mainstream media not are revealing to the people.
Yeah.
That's
a
joke.
And this is a big thing in
but
Sweden.
It was a big difference in the numbers in arrest in Norway and Sweden.
Yeah.
And that's not unexpected, because...
Yes,
I don't know. Yeah, it is. And people around the world have noticed Sweden as a bad example for how bad it can be with multiculturalism and globalism. And Norway, the neighbor country, haven't been hit so hard yet by the same in the same level that they have been in Sweden. So we know the difference, but... can you tell our listeners why it is that kind of difference in Norway and Sweden? We can see now in some of those, what do you call it, forort?
The cities, those...
parts of the cities.
Yeah.
Some parts of the big cities, they have the gang members or it's foreign-related people that have took over parts of the city, and they have... roadblocks, and they control it completely.
Yeah.
We don't see that in Norway yet. But why it is so bad in Sweden compared to Norway?
Actually, because the police hasn't done anything. They have seen these gangs coming and taking over, but the police hasn't done enough. There have been articles where we've seen that the police, they have visited the criminals, and they are trying to give them pizza, they are trying to play with them, they are trying to give them buns and things like that. You can't do that.
No, and they have going in the same path for at least 20, 30 years, and that haven't worked. It's been worse and worse. But they're still going in the same direction.
Yeah, there were some people now writing yesterday in the articles in Sweden. The opinion is that they should take the military force now into those cities where their gangs are ruling, because the police doesn't, they can't do anything.
Yeah, and what we're hearing by the mainstream media and everyone, maybe all around the world, is that what you're saying now, that is extremist left right extremist propaganda, and it's not that bad. Sweden is a good country. They've never been safer, as the Prime Minister Stefan Löfven said. We can listen to them, and they can listen to alternative medias, but you have lived there.
I have lived there. I've seen it.
And you know how it is.
Yeah.
Is it right? Is it like that?
Yeah. Yes, it is like that. And the place outside Stockholm I was living, I was working, I'm a gardener, so I was working in forests and parks and stuff like that. The first years when I took that job, it was actually quite good. But the last season I was working in Sweden, they were actually shooting people in the parks. They were killing people with knives. As a lady, I couldn't go out for a walk for the two last years. If I didn't have my pistol and some knife with me, I couldn't walk outside. So it was pretty bad. And I think it's like 5 or 10 ladies are raped daily in Sweden.
Mm. And the problem is that is that people get used to it. It's the normal. Yeah. It's the new normal. And I remember before you moved here to Norway with me, so I was talking with you. We had a live show. We had the first live show we had together when you were sitting outside Stockholm.
Yeah.
And I heard some, and after the show, we, sorry, we had a talk after that, and I heard some shooting, some bangs in the background, yeah. And I asked you, what is that? And you said so relaxed, oh, someone shooting.
So is that normal in Sweden?
it's very dangerous, yeah. That one get used to that.
Yeah, and it's also bombing. And a new thing is that those the violence against kids, youngsters, they are taking their clothes off and pissing on them and say, you should kiss my shoes. Kiss my shoes or I kill you.
And then you get a kick in the face.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, that's new.
Yeah, and that's called, what is the English word for that?
Humiliation
violence, yes. Humiliation, yeah. Robbery. Not to just to take their things, but they want to humiliate them. Yeah. And that is first and foremost Muslim gangs that are doing that.
Yeah. Actually, I could tell a pretty cool thing. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, it's not cool. I told you, I was working in forests and gardening. In parks, and the place I lived in, they had 10 of these what did you call it?
maybe it's the right word of yours, can adjust us about that, but humiliation
violence.
Robbery?
Yeah,
humiliation robbery, maybe?
Anyway, they were robbering kids and youths, and police didn't do anything, and the governors of the cities didn't do anything. But there was one kid who was robbed, and he was a son of a politician.
Mm. Okay. And what
and
happened then?
After that, the politician called the company I was working for, and he was so upset. He said, I can't accept this. You have to cut down all trees in the park. So you can see who is walking there, who is hiding behind the bushes. And that was only because his son got robbed.
And then they think different suddenly.
Yeah.
And that's the way about with the effects of multiculturalism. Separate people. If you say you love that and you're going along with the mainstream story, your son could still get robbed and humiliated. Yeah. They make no difference. They think so. If they're good to those gangs or about the migrants and talk good about them, they think they are safe, but they're not.
Anyway, if you don't believe us, you can put on the Sputnik link, because I can read to you what the...
Sputnik!
What the head of the Gothenburg police area says. His name is Erik Nord. And this one is from last week. The article, it's called "No Longer a Secret, Swedish Police Chief Links Deadly Shootings to Immigration." Mm-hmm. And he actually says, basically everyone who shots or is shot in gang conflicts or originates from the Balkans, the Middle East, North or East Africa. And he says also he admitted a link between mass shootings and immigration. And then we had the Swedish Crime Prevention Council, BRÅ. They recently made a report. And in the report said, Sweden is the only country in Europe where fatal shootings are on the rise. And that Sweden has the second most fatal shootings in Europe after Croatia.
And let's have a bet. How long will that, what's the police chief?
Erik Nord, he's from Gothenburg.
Yeah, how long will he keep his job?
Yeah.
You can't say that. You can't say that in
you can't
Sweden
say that. You get
or
fired.
Norway or any other white country.
Yeah.
You can't. That's good, Annelise. Should we take a look at the last one you got here within the same subject?
Yeah, it's the violence, and we actually talked about it earlier. It's the gangs in Sweden who are responsible for that. I made a short video a half year ago because I think it's like it's war. What do you call it when it's inside a country?
Civil war.
Civil war. Yeah, it's civil war in Sweden. And why can I say it's civil war? Yes, because the government and the police, they can't handle the situation. The gangs are taking control over whole Sweden. They are running everything. Mm. And people don't know it. The article, it's from The Guardian. Sweden gun violence rate has soared due to gangs. Sweden is the only European country where fatal shootings have risen significantly since 2000. The Swedish National Council for Crime Prevention, BRÅ, said the Scandinavian country had overtaken Italy and Eastern European countries primarily because of the violent activities of organized criminal gangs.
Mm, exactly.
Yeah.
And we will... that was some... cases, some news from Scandinavia, from Sweden, but we will not have only from our countries. We will have some news while we are doing this from all over the world.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll see it with Scandinavian eyes, but this is not a Nordic Scandinavian show in that matter. It will be worldwide, and we will. Make you comfortable. We will play some music. Let's do that now and go back to some other stuff from New York this time. What do you say about that, Annelie?
Sounds good.
Queen, you make my heart.
That was nice music. We also try to play some alternative music, not the music that you hear on the playlist on the radios all day long, but we are taking a look around on YouTube and every places to find something people haven't heard before.
Yeah.
And we don't have to come in confrontation with the copyrights and stuff like that.
That's
so
good.
That's the way we have done it for 2 years in Norway, and now we try to do it in the world, all around
getting
the world.
Bigger.
Getting bigger. Yes, I'm thinking about what you said recently now, Anneli. Why it happened like that? Because it don't happen like that in countries that are not run by the, a white majority. It happened in white countries. It seems like people don't have the, I don't know, have the guts or don't want to talk up or stand up for themselves and resist these crazy things that happen. Maybe it's many things that have led to that.
It's many
because
things.
It's propaganda that are going all over the world, especially in white countries, how bad the white people are. You have to apologize for the slavery that have been ended in America, far away from here, for 150 years before we were born. And you're kneeling about it, and you can't talk about that. And if you resist that, you're a racist, a Nazi, and so on, fascist.
Yeah.
And one of the things that are doing that are the propaganda. I have one case here, and that propaganda that is so racist and so anti-white and so hateful. I sometimes haven't seen that by Hitler either, talking so bad about Jews that some people can do now about white people and get away with it.
Yeah.
I think
it's
that's
crazy.
A part of the things that are have got us here we are now. We have one case here from from the New York Post, a mainstream media. I think it's surprising that they have talked about this. There's a shrink, a psychiatrist that had what do you call it? A conference, maybe on
some kind of speech in the university,
Yale University, in New York, and she was talking about she had fantasized about shooting white people in the head. A New York, according to New York Poster, a New York City-based psychiatrist told an audience at the Yale School of Medicine in April that she had fantasies of unloading a revolver into the head of any white person that got in her way.
She's sick.
Audio of the talk was posted on the Substack online platform of former New York Times opinion writer and editor Barry Weiss on Friday, along with an interview of Kilani. Her name is Dr. Aruna Kilaniani.
But she looks white.
It sounds like an Italian name, but according to I don't think I found it according to New York Post, but some other place that she is Indian origin.
Yeah.
Her ancestor from India. Maybe she was born in USA, but anyway. I said that one. It was on a podcast with the podcaster Katie Herzog. Barry Weiss, by the way, is a former commentator and editor on the New York Post or New York Times. Yeah, New York Times. So she was the one who has published this audio for the first time. And Aruna called that also said that we are calm, and she had then talking about people of color. That means everyone on this planet except from the white minority of the planet. We are calm, we are giving, too giving, and then we get angry. They use our responses and as confirmation that we're crazy or have emotional problems, she said. It always ends that way. Happenings every time. Like a goddamn timer, you can count on it. Yeah, you can count down. And she said, nothing makes me more angrier than a white person who tells me not to be angry because they have not seen real anger yet. Before talking about, she said that before she was talking about how she systematically cut off most of her former white friends around 5 years ago. She was cutting away those friends because they are white.
That's racism.
That's pure racism to say that she's talking about every white people. She don't make any exceptions. She don't say most of the white people are okay, but there are some. She's not saying that. White people are that way.
Shocking.
It was also, she said, it was also a public service. I had fantasies of unloading a revolver into the head of any white person that got in my way, as I said. Burying their body and wiping my bloody hands as I walked away, relatively guiltless, with a bones in my step, like I did a world a fucking favor.
Oh my God.
What would happen if any white person said that about all black people or all Jews or all Arabs?
Well, that person would be almost arrested. That person couldn't walk on the streets after that. She or he would be beaten up, got fired from the job, everything.
Mm. And she said white people are out of their minds. When she said that, she means everyone, okay?
Okay.
Including my five months old granddaughter. She's out of my mind. And they have been for a long time. White people feel that we are bullying them when we bring up race, she said. And this is the same kind of people that say that she belonged to those progressive globalist people that say there's no such thing as a race, color, difference, sex sometimes, or what to call it, genders,
yeah.
Nothing like that. There's only individual people, and that's how we have to measure people. They always say that. But people like this can say this about white people. How far did they get now? She said, we keep forgetting, this is hard stuff, we keep forgetting that directly talking about race is a waste of our breath. Kiliani continued, we are asking a demented, violent predator who thinks that they are a saint or a superhero to accept responsibility. It ain't gonna happen. They have five holes in their brain. White people also. It's like banging your head into a brick wall. Kaliani said that addressing racism assumes that white people can see and process what we are talking about. They can't, she said. That's why they sound demented. They don't even know that they have a mask on. White people think it's their actual face. We need to get to know their mask. I've never heard anyone talk so racist, to be a racist like that. Not even Hitler talking about Jews. No. He didn't say something like this.
Yeah. You actually can't say that to... in a school, in university, that you have fantasies about shooting people?
Wanting to have fantasy about shooting people, but to have fantasy to whiting, to shoot people because they belong to an ethnic group.
I think she's sick.
I've never heard anything racist
like
that. Was
she a shrink or something?
A psychiatrist and what's all the thing that with psyche?
Because actually, I think she needs to go to a psychiatrist.
Yeah, and she's treating people, and I saw on her TikTok account. And she is still doing that racist stuff there, and that's saying that the white people don't get what she's saying. So they don't understand stuff like other people. White people are the worst thing that. But I wonder what is her final solution? She also said in this according to this article that. There's no point in talking with white people like with this. You can't solve it with talking with them. They will never understand it because they're white. So I wonder, what is her final solution? Yeah. Shooting or guessing? What is the solution it seems like if you just hate white people enough, racism will disappear from the planet. It seems like that.
But did you notice what she said? She said that no one has noticed how angry they could be yet.
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
I think that just sounds wait and see. A little bit like a threat.
Yeah, you can see on South Africa what happened when the demonization of white people getting far enough, and white people at the end will be a minority in the country they were at start a majority too. Remember Joe Biden said it was long before the election that white people will not continue to be the majority of America, and that's a good thing, he said. He said that.
This is the thing, things like that scares me, that she actually can say things like that and nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
No one gets angry. No one says, you can't speak like this. That's racism. You can't, that's actually a threat against white people. No one does anything.
No, they don't. And we can see here in Norway and Sweden and maybe the rest of the world that... In white countries, they are searching to find any tiny kind of racism. If they're in one company, there is not enough percent of the employees that are people of color. They are racist. They are so fine-tuned on this. But if it's against white people, you can just spew it out and burst it out. Yeah. Everything that what's in your racist head. We said that,
but it's coming more and more. I remember the video we showed in our Norwegian live show from the school. I don't remember every details. Maybe you remember. There was somebody asking, are you really trying to learn kids to hate white people? And I don't know if he was a teacher or something, but he admitted
it. No, yeah, I think it was in USA.
Yeah.
We had it in the show, right? And he admitted that.
Yeah.
That's what they were doing.
Yeah.
And they do it with no negative response from any... politician high up in the system? Not at all.
It's a hidden agenda.
Hidden agenda?
Yeah.
We have, I think we stopped this broadcast now, Anneli, and for the first time, this was our, premiere?
La première.
La première on our English version of Alternativ Media. Show. So please follow us. We are, we had this one on Twitch. We will, I think we will save this, the video of this. We have looking around for other platforms than Facebook because they are getting real different. They have blocked many of our shows lately.
Yeah.
And you can find us on DLive, Twitch, YouTube, Trivo. Trovo. I don't know how you pronounce it. Trovo. 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 New platform, I think. What's the more? We are on Facebook too, but we will leave Facebook and DLive, of course. Mm. So find us there. And we will, when we have no... we have to practice our English a bit. We have to try it out. And when we have done that now. And we will have broadcast in English on DLive, Twitch, YouTube, Facebook, and Trovo. So find us there on those platforms. Follow us. And you get notification when we start.
Yeah.
So... You used
see,
to see,
see you guys.
You used to see, have a nice weekend.
Yeah. I was thinking, what should I say? What should I say? Then, see you.
See you next time.
See you next time.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. Ooh.